Hello everyone, I am Lee Shinan, a Huawei instructor. Now let's start with section 3, the upgrade of VLAN devices. This upgrade of VLAN devices includes the upgrade of ACs and also the upgrade of APs. First, let's take a look at the AC upgrade. Why do we need to upgrade devices? Because our devices operate on an operating system. We know that whether we use PCs with Windows or Apple's systems, our systems need to be upgraded constantly. The same applies to Huawei's network devices. Both our hardware and software may encounter the need for upgrades. So in our daily work, we must know how to perform these upgrades. So what are the benefits of upgrading? Some are listed here. Of course, the benefits are not limited to these. Fixing system vulnerabilities, optimizing system resources, and adding new features are some of the obvious benefits. Let's first look at how to upgrade the AC. Previously, I talked about how to operate our file system and how to log in. Now, we'll put that into use. Because when we upgrade, first, we need to download the upgrade software to our local computer. Then, we need to transfer this software to the AC. There are actually several methods to transfer the software to the AC. We can use a PC as an FTP or SFTP server. Then the AC logs onto the PC to retrieve it. Alternatively, the AC can act as the server. And after the PC logs into the AC, the file can be placed onto the server. There are many methods that can be used to transfer files from the PC to the AC. Once that is done, we can load the system software for the next boot and process the device. This way, our device will boot using the new system file. That's the whole principle of upgrading. In practical terms, the first step is to check the version of the system software and confirm the version. Some upgrades have specific version requirements. For example, if your version is too old, it may not be possible to upgrade directly to the latest version, and some intermediate versions might be required. First, we must determine the new version, which is the software version. After confirming the software version and verifying that our upgrade package can be used with this version, we can then proceed to the next steps. The next step is to download the new software to the AC. In our example here, our PC acts as the FTP server, and the AC is the client. After FTPing into the PC from the AC, enter the correct username, followed by the correct password, you will be logged in successfully. Once logged in, we use the get command to download the latest software version. Upon executing this command, you will observe some processes and finally receive a notification. File has been saved successfully, indicating the transfer is complete and the file has been properly stored on our device. Now the file is ready. The next step after downloading is to update the startup system software using the command startup system software, followed by specifying the file name. After completion, you can verify with display startup which system software will be used at the next startup. This will differ from the software used at this startup. You will notice that the versions are different. Thus, by restarting our system, it will boot with the newly updated software version. This concludes the upgrade process. That's the AC upgrade process. First, ensure the network is properly set up before proceeding. Then we need to load our software by any means necessary onto the AC and set it for the next startup from the AC, booting from the new software version. This completes the upgrade. This AC upgrade is relatively simple. Now let's look at the upgrade of the AP. The upgrade of this AP is actually controlled by the AC. You see this diagram, it shows the AC distributing software to the AP. So based on this situation, similarly, we first need to download the software to the computer and then through FTP or SFTP, download the system software onto the AC. The next step requires setting the AP upgrade mode to AC mode, which means using the AC to upgrade the AP. Finally, of course, we need to set the AC's upgrade version with the file name and AP type. Let's look at the detailed operational process. First, we need to check the type of AC that needs to be upgraded. Display AP type all. Using this command, we can find that ID 115 is the AC type that needs to be upgraded. Then, at the head of the WLAN protocol, we use the command AP update mode, AC mode, to set the AC to upgrade the AP. Then, for the second step, AP update update file name. This is the name of the file used for the upgrade, which is a long file name ending with the extension bin. Then here enter AP type 115E, which is this type. This is the AP model. Next, we use the command display AP all to check the information about the APs coming online. Looking here, the AP is now online, but its state is download, not normal, indicating that we are currently operating on this AP. Here, we can check our current upgrade status, update status all. Here we can see this model of AP is in a state of downloading, currently downloading. And then the following is the progress, 100%. It is now completed 47%. This is how we check the upgrade status of the AP. After the upgrade is finished, we need to check the online status of the AP again to see if it is normal using the command display AP all. Looking here, the state has changed to normal. NOR means normal. This indicates that our AP upgrade is complete and it is now online. Let's compare previously during the upgrade, our state was download, but later changed to normal, indicating success. Here, it tells us how to restart the AP. If there are issues with this AP and we want to restart it, we can use these commands. If it's a single AP, each AP will have a unique AP ID. This AP ID is unique, so we can directly use AP reset and add AP ID 0E. This way, we can restart the AP with ID 0. If we want to restart a category, use the keyword AP type. The type ID is 75. So if we want to restart a group, because in our AP and AC settings, we have the concept of an AP group. If we add some APs to a group, we can restart all the APs in that group by restarting the group directly. This restarts all the APs inside. The last one is AP all, which means indiscriminately, all APs under this AC, all restart. This is the method to restart APs. That concludes section 3, device upgrades. The most important aspect of device upgrades is we need to place the upgrade package. Whether upgrading the AC or the AP, we need to put the upgrade package on the AC. Then on the AC, if upgrading, just switch our next startup software to the new upgrade package. And if upgrading the AP, we need to use the AC to upgrade the AP. Our operation is performed on the AC. Everyone should be aware of this.